Have you ever wondered what the key aspects are that have an influence on growing your koi? With this video, we will explain you 11 factors that do have an influence on the growth rate of your koi. So after watching this video, you will know how you can optimize the circumstances to make the growth rate of your koi even better. And of course, as always, please ask questions in the comments and I will do my best to give you a reply or even answer your question in one of the next videos. Food and nutrition is the first one to start with that really does have a large effect. The most important ingredient for growth is protein. And not just protein, but protein from aquatic life, like fish and shrimps. Hence, fish meal is one of the key ingredients of a good koi food. Make sure that the main ingredient is fish meal. That will also mean that the most protein in the koi food will be derived from fish. The first ingredient listed on the bag of koi food is the most used ingredient in that specific bag of food. So when you read fish meal as first ingredient, you know that this koi food is mainly based on fish meal. And you know you have to skip the bag of food if you want good growth rates if it mentions wheat flour as first ingredient. For younger koi, I recommend searching for about 40 to 45% of protein. For older koi, it is okay to lower the amount of protein to about 35 to 40%. If you look at the different brands in the market, there are several good ones available. I think most of the koi foods nowadays are actually quite good. And using these basics, you can easily find a good one. If you look at breeders in Japan, high-end hobbyists and several koi dealers, I will suggest to look for Hikari. Especially the Saki Hikari line has good protein levels and can assure you good growth results. The second factor that has a big influence is feeding multiple times a day. Feeding one time a day won't help you to reach good growth rates, but overfeeding also won't help. So the best thing to do is feeding your koi multiple times a day, preferable about 6 or even 7 times daily. Doing this in nicely divided proportions multiple times a day will help to increase the nutritional intake. To do this, you could make use of an autofeeder that starts already early in the morning. Most breeders I've been at during summertime feed their koi about 6, 7 or 8 times a day, from baby koi up to their larger koi. The third factor is water quality. When you really want to have good growth rates, you need to make sure your water quality is optimal. That starts with no ammonia, nitrate and nitrite in your water. But did you know that actually the TDS value, total dissolved solids, is one of the main drivers for growth when talking about water quality? The lower the TDS value, the easier koi tend to grow. The TDS value is based on all dissolved solids in your water. It basically counts up everything, including the carbonate and bicarbonate in your water. So that means if your water hardness is lower, like a lower GH value and carbonate level, you can have better growth rates. And now you will probably ask me, like, how do I then lower the TDS value in order to increase the growth rate of my koi? And that brings us to the fourth factor, doing regular water changes. Overall, we can say that water changes help to lower the TDS value and improve the water quality. Often rinsing away about 10 to 15% of your water and changing it will help to lower the TDS value, ammonia and nitrite levels for example. And in almost all circumstances, using tap water will be okay. Unless you are making use of, for example, an RO installation on your pond. In that situation, you will actually increase the TDS value. Water temperature is the fifth factor and it can really have a large effect on the growth rate of your koi. For young koi, water temperatures of about 24 to 26 degrees are best for high growth rates. So if you really want to improve the growth rate of your koi, you should make sure that you reach 24 degrees. So you should heat your pond a little bit extra to reach this temperature, especially for a growing project. But please take into account that when you grow out colored koi like Gosanke with red on it, for longer periods at higher water temperatures, it may happen that the red color is starting to disappear. And this is especially happening when there is not enough sunlight. So growing indoors at high temperatures without sunlight is not always a good idea. The sixth factor are the genetics of koi, and this is the same as with humans. Genetics are the key factor in determining the maximum size, so this is just the same as for koi. And in Japan, breeders make or made use of different ways to enlarge their bloodlines, so to make sure that koi grow as large as possible. So what I tried to do in the past is combine larger bloodlines and varieties with their koi in order to enlarge the potential of large koi. And the exact same thing applies to the body posture. Breeders tend to combine parent koi with great bodies in order to maximize the body posture of their koi. The seventh but not less important factor is space and environment to grow in. Breeders make use of mud ponds, which are actually really large growing areas that are not crowded with koi. They offer a lot of space for each single koi, and for that reason the growth and speed of growth is tremendous. A basic rule of thumb is to use about 1000 liters for each koi, but you can imagine that in a large mud pond each koi will at least have over 10,000 liters of water. For your own pound, I recommend to go no higher than one koi for about 1500 up to 2000 liters of water. I know that this can be quite difficult to not buy too many koi and overstock your pound, but believe me that it really has a large effect on the growth rate of your koi. Factor number 8 is oxygen. Oxygen also has to do with good conditions for your koi. Always aerate your pound or make sure there is water sprinkling or streaming. There are several koi leaders and hobbyists that do mention that high oxygen levels do improve the growth rate of koi. Personally, I only partly believe in this. I've seen very high growth rates in mud ponds in Japan that are not even aerated at all. In my opinion, you want to have sufficient oxygen, but don't overdo it. Take into account when you heat your pond that water can contain less oxygen. So the warmer water is, the less oxygen it can contain. So when you heat your pound, always aerate a little bit extra. Also, the age of a koi has an effect on the growth rate. Hence we have age as number 9. The younger a koi is, the faster it can grow. Koi up to about 3 to 4 years old will simply grow at a faster pace than older koi. Under very good conditions, tosai, so koi that are younger than 1 year old, can grow about 1 cm in 1 week. And for that reason, there are breeders in Japan that grow their 1-year-old koi to sizes up to above 40 or even 50 cm in size. Now of course you cannot influence age, but what you can do is make sure at a young age you try to make the circumstances as good as possible. That will ensure the koi can make the best progress in its first few years. Number 10 is about the effect of gender on the growth rate. So there is an effect of gender on the growth rate, but I would say this is only small at a younger age. And overall, female koi will of course become larger than male koi in the long run. At a young age, sometimes male koi are actually growing faster than female koi. So I would say that there is actually no difference between the growth rate of a female and a male koi. But of course, it is more likely if you have a female koi that it will reach a larger size, simply because female koi will grow larger. Factor number 11 is water flow. So will water flow actually affect the growth rate of your koi? Honestly, I think not. You probably have seen these large mud ponds in Japan where koi grow during summertime. Water in these ponds is not moving at all. Sometimes there's even zero aeration, zero pumps or movement of the water. And have you seen the growth rates in there? It is impressive. Water flow can surely help though to maintain better water quality, but personally I would suggest to not overdo it with flow. Just make sure that there is enough circulation in your pond. This will ensure oxygen levels stay higher and circulation for your filtration system. With these 11 factors you can reach maximum growth of your koi, but remember that it is most important to provide good conditions. This will ensure healthy and happy koi. Koi will grow by itself, as long as you do your best to maintain the circumstances as good as possible. If you have any questions regarding the growth of your koi, please feel free to ask it in the comments. I will do my best to answer your questions or answer it in one of the upcoming videos. Hopefully you enjoyed this video and learned something new. If you liked the video, please consider to subscribe to our YouTube channel. That way you will stay up to date with all new videos. Thank you for watching and see you in our next video.